All people come to him, come to the way, O Sultan Al-Anbiya, most honored one and most glorified one. السلام عليكم يا شاه مرضان. الله الله. حضرت علي بن أبي طالب رضي الله عنه كرم الله وجهه، ما شاء الله. أي شاه مرضان،
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. These 2 weeks, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. It's an honor to be among you. If not for you, I'm going to speak to whom? So I need you. That's why I'm here. Because everyone is a flower to Mawlana Sheikh. Everyone is a different color, different taste of honey that bees are sucking from the flowers. Every one of us is dear to Mawlana Sheikh. Nazim, may Allah bless his soul.
Amen.
And that's why Grand Sheikh used to say that Awliyaullah are in need for the murids. Murids not in need for the sheikh. But the sheikh is in need for the murid, because if there was no murid, what is going to do? To whom he is going to speak? So he is in need for the murids. He said more than that, but I cannot say it. I will keep this. But I say, Ya Sayyidi Ya Rasulullah, Ya Habib Allah, Ya Qurrat al-A'yun, Ya Man Arsalak Allah Ta'ala Rahmatan Lil'alameen, Ya Shafi' al-Mudnibin, Anta al-Mudafi' an al-Mazlumin, Anta al-Nabi, Anta al-Rasul, Anta al-Habib الذي ترجى شفاعته لكل هول من الأهوال مقتحم. نحن في أهوال كثيرة ونحن على أبواب حروب، فنرجو يا رسول الله أن تجعلنا بين يديك وتحت رجليك إن شاء الله. ولو أنهم إذ ظلموا أنفسهم جاءوك، نحن ظلمنا يا رسول الله، نحن مظلومون، we are oppressed. When someone is have sins, they come to you to ask Allah forgiveness. But those who are being oppressed, they also come to you to relieve them from their oppression. We are being oppressed by close people to us. We are being oppressed of giving 60 years of our life to the love of a Grand Sheikh, Sheikh Abdullah Al-Faz Al-Dawastani, and to the love of Mawlana Sheikh Nazim. We are oppressed. Allah said, إن الله يدافع عن الذين آمنوا. Allah will defend those believers. Allah will defend them, those who are being oppressed. لا يحب الله الجهر بالسوء إلا من ظلم. Allah doesn't like anyone to say something not nice except when he is being oppressed. they are oppressing us and they are trying their best to corner us and to put us in the corner and then smack us. But you have lions, Ya Rasulullah. You have Shah Mardan, Ya Rasulullah. Ya Sayyidina Ali. Ya Ali.
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 Ya Asadullah Al-Ghalib. Anta qala an-nabiyyu fi haqqik. Prophet said, أنا مدينة العلم وعلي بابها. I am the city of knowledge and Ali is the door. We know that you defend us. You and Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and سيدنا أبو بكر الصديق and سيدنا علي كرم الله وجهه and سيدنا عثمان and سيدنا عمر and all صحابة. Because we are oppressed. Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, why Mawlana Sheikh Nazim for many, many times, many months and more than 1 year, he was always calling on Shah Mardan, on Sayyidina Ali. Why he has to call on Sayyidina Ali? Because they are feeling that oppression is coming. They know that their oppression is coming into dividing the tariqah, which is contrary of what Allah said. وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. Hold tight to the rope of Allah and don't separate. Ya Sayyidi Ya Rasul Allah, Ya Habib Allah, الشُّكْرُ لَكْ وَالْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ والعظمة والكبرياء لله والمحبة لله ولك. ولذلك جئتنا ببشارة كبيرة, بشارة عظيمة. You came to us because glory is for Allah, love is for Allah and to you. Praises to Allah and to you. Mercy to Allah and to you. You came to us to relieve us, to release us from this oppression. Oppression that is being done by the one that we love. That's what it hurt. That when you love someone, you raise someone and you get from him, instead of sweet words, you get rude words. But never mind. I am, and I don't like to say I am, but because it happened, I'm very happy, Ya Sayyidi Ya Rasulallah, for the dream that I saw with you. I saw you in the dream. I was so depressed at that night, one night, like 2 months ago. I was so depressed and being oppressed and being stressed out. I rendered the matter to Allah and His Prophet. Allah knows best, Prophet knows best. And that night, I prayed Fajr and then I slept and رأيت ما يراه النائم في المنام. I saw in the dream, it's like a vision, it's not really a ما بين النوم واليقظة. Between sleeping and awake, that the whole dunya gone and there is only one huge dome that cover the whole dunya. And that dome full of light. I'm not saying this proud or arrogant. No, astaghfirullah. I am the one that don't deserve to be even at the threshold, at the shoes of people. We are not arrogant. Maulana polished us very well. Two sheikhs from the Naqshbandi order of the Dagestani branch. And many shuyukh from the other branches that they used to come to our home, because our home, my father, alhamdulillah, was in good wealth, as a huge house. This masjid is like one room in that house. All ulama, all scholars, they come, all awliya, they come. We've been raised in the lap of awliya. Not only one wali or two walis. Not only in Grand Sheikh with and Maulana Sheikh, this is our shuyukh, we are proud of them. But in many other shuyukh of different tariqah and even Naqshbandi tariqah. And mostly Naqshbandi, Qadiri, Shazili. They were raising us on their laps. Every day we have one or two or three guests coming from Syria or from all over the world, coming and staying in our house, hosting them, and they speak, they have like circles of ilm with my uncle. I slept, between sleeping and non-sleeping, I saw this whole world disappear and this huge dome. And many people in the back. And I am with them, standing. And I saw all this big dome, huge, like the horizon to the horizon, opened. I said, why I have to stay here? I heard that Prophet is there. So I walked. And everyone else is in the back. No one was ordered to move. I moved until I reached people in line for prayer, and they were waiting Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I approached and I stood between the lines, behind, directly where Prophet, the Imam, is going to stand. I heard a voice saying that the Prophet is not coming now. He is on the second floor. He is there, going to lead the prayer from there. Not from the main floor. But I said, why I have to stay in the main floor? I will go to the second floor. I went up to the second floor. And I saw Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam standing like that. And speaking and moving his hands. I felt afraid, but I approached. There was that line there, there was a line, and Prophet speaking to that line of people, is the core of Muslims. What you call the core of Muslims? The inside.
Heartland.
Heart of the, yani, the essence, the elite of Muslims, that they carry the message after Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam spreading it. I stood between them. Said, why I have to sit? But I felt, I'm listening and listening, and I heard that a voice saying, "Inna Allah yudafi'u 'ani alladhina amanu." Allah defend those who are believers. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I was looking and he was defending me.
Allahu Akbar.
Takbir.
Allahu Akbar.
What was strange is that I'm seeing Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and in an instant turning to look Mawlana Sheikh Nazim. Then the other instant turn back to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to see Prophet. Then turns back, turns another time, it looks and see Mawlana Sheikh Nazim. And both of them were in defending and speaking, but I was not able to know or to understand what they were saying. But what I know what they are were saying, that they are defending me by Allah's order. Ya Sayyidi Ya Rasulallah, that was enough for me. Whoever wants to say anything, let him say. I have my, my diamond, my medallion from Prophet and from Mawlana Sheikh. It's enough for me and for all of you. So what is then? That was the dream. And it has many meanings. We are not going to go to the meanings, but this is the main issue, is when you are really, they are concerned about you, awliyaullah or Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, concerned about you, and they know you are oppressed, mazloom, they support. They don't leave someone who gave to Grand Sheikh and Mawlana Sheikh Nazim 60 years of age, 60 years working for da'wah, for Islam, me or my brother. We are getting a lot of slap from day one. From when we were young, because people, they were saying, why the Grand Sheikh is not loving our children like he loved these two children? From that time. They are not saying everything. That time, not even Baha or Muhammad being born. But the issue now is why Mawlana Sheikh for 1 year or more, every Fajr he was calling on Ya Shah Mardan. Ya Shah Mardan. Is that? Hayyaran. Ya Shah Mardan. Who is Shah Mardan? Sayyidina Ali Karramallahu Wajha. Every sentence or sentence he say Ya Shah Mardan. Ya Shah Mardan. Because Grand Sheikh, may Allah bless his soul,
Amen.
Spoke about the last days. And this is his story. This is Awliya's story. It's not Ulama's story. That when Sayyidina Ali Karramallahu Wajha been stabbed, he asked before he gave his soul, that when after you wash me, put me on the camel and don't follow me. It's not. This is in history. He can confirm or he cannot confirm. If he, yes, it's correct. So when they put him and let the camel to move. And the camel went in the desert and disappeared. And they were waiting, Sahaba. Until some people, caravan came from the other side. This is where I think أولياء الله visions. They said to the caravan, did you see a camel on top of it, someone deceased body of Sayyidina Ali? They said, no, we didn't see. We saw Shah Mardan sitting on the camel running.
Allahu Akbar!
Hadi!
Ya Ali!
Hadi!
Ya Ali!
Hadi!
Ya Ali!
Allah gave what He wants to give. No one can say no. Kun fayakun. You believe or you don't believe, no one is taking your opinion. That grand sheikh. He said, when the order comes for Mahdi alayhi salam to come, changes will happen because he is grandson of Sayyidina Ali. That's why Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, they say they don't know where is Sayyidina Ali being buried. It's not in Karbala. In Karbala, yeah, Sayyidina al-Hussein was killed. But they have a mazar for Sayyidina Ali, but Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah scholar, they say no. It's, no one knows where he is. No awliya Allah knows. He has something to do. One time Sayyidina Fatima al-Zahra, عليها السلام رضي الله تعالى عنها وأرضاها. She was not happy. And this is also from a grand sheikh. She was not happy. And Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم loves her a lot. And she loves her father a lot. Not? More than any of his wives. More than Sayyida Aisha. She went to her father, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Subhanallah. How much she is lucky. She is our mother. May Allah keep us under her in day of judgment.
Ameen.
And in dunya and akhirah. The Prophet looked at her. Are you not happy when Prophet look at you? We will be sell this whole dunya for a gaze from Prophet to us. The whole universe is not worthy, valuable as a look from Prophet on us. This qasaid, from where it comes? From the heart, from ishq. They are singing with ishq. So he said to her, Ya Fatima, Ya Fatima, what you have? Why you are sad? She said, Ya Sayyidi, Ya Rasulullah, Ya Abi. I don't like to complain. He said, what? Is there a problem with Sayyidina Ali? She said, not a problem. But Sayyidina Ali sometimes doesn't sleep at home. One day or 2 days, and then he comes. I never asked him where he goes. Today, if you are late at home 1 hour, Allah knows what will happen to that. Might be the television will be broken. Everything will be broken. Man and woman, same. If the wife goes to visit her cousin or her brother or her mother, oh, the husband also the same, isn't it? You are like that? His heart doesn't care. So she said, Ya Rasulallah, Ya Habibi, Ya Abi. Sometimes he doesn't come to the house, he doesn't, 1 day, 2 days, maximum 3 days. He said, Ya Fatima, don't open this subject to anyone. He is not لا يغيب بدون إذني.
He doesn't go away except with my permission.
He doesn't go away without my permission. I'm giving him permission to go somewhere. That's why he's busy. Pray for him. She said, Ya Rasulallah, I am happy now because he is doing khidmah for you. He said, I will tell you that I send him because in this universe Allah created creations, and the nearest one to earth, the dangerous one. If they invade the earth, the earth will be finished. They will kill everyone. I sent Sayyidina Ali to fight them alone, to these aliens, that they are the most nearest to earth. And with his sword and his power, he is Asadullah al-Ghalib, destroyed 2/3 of them. That's why they don't have power anymore to come on earth. That's why I send him, he is absent from the house. That's why Maulana is calling on Shah Mardan. Why not on Abu Bakr al-Siddiq or Sayyidina Umar or Sayyidina Uthman? He calls on them, but every one of them, Allah gave him khususiyah. What khususiyah? Specialty. Something special for him to do. They don't take something that doesn't belong to them. It's not like people in Islam, in Sharia or Mazahib, they try to take from here and here. And now in Tariqa, they try to make confusion because they want the biggest cake. They think that there is cake there. They don't know that cake is from Allah. If Allah will stop it, will stop it. And Allah did stop it.
Allahu Akbar.
When he was calling, Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan, say Ya Shahi Mardan, 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 Inna Nubayuk,
Inna Nubayuk,
we are giving him our bay'ah by saying, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. وأشهد أن محمد رسول بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الذين يبايعونك إنما يبايعون الله يد الله فوق أيديهم فمن نكث فإنما ينكث على نفسه ومن أوفى بما عاهد عليه الله سيؤتيه أجرا عظيما رضينا بالله ربا وبالإسلام دينا وبسيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم رسولا ونبيا وبالقرآن كتابا والله على ما نقول وكيل وقبلنا بسيد الشيخ محمد ناظم الحقاني وسيد الشيخ عبد الله الفائز الدارستاني وشاه مردان وإمامنا المهدي المنتظر وكلنا لرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ملتمس وإلى حضرة النبي الفاتحة. So he calls on Shah Mardan, and he kept calling Ya Shahi Mardan, the secret ready, I pulled it up. The secret of the Naqshbandi order, I am giving it to you now. This is your job, you handling it. Because Grand Sheikh, may Allah bless his soul,
Ameen.
He said that all tariqat, including Naqshbandi, all tariqat, when the Sheikh of that tariqa leaves dunya in this time, leaves dunya, Imam Mahdi or Sayyidina Ali hold it, hold the secret of the tariqa. Now most of the tariqas, he used to say, are being held, they are on hold, because they are coming from Sayyidina Ali and Sayyidina Abu Bakr. They are on hold, in hand of Sayyidina Ali, in hand of Sayyidina al-Mahdi. Except the Naqshbandi tariqa, still it is dripping. And with the going of Mawlana Sheikh Nazim before he is leaving dunya, he's calling on Shahi Mardan, come and take the secret of this tariqa to keep it as you kept everything else. That is a secret that Mawlana has sent it to understand what is the meaning of calling on Shahi Mardan. That secret cannot be done in 5 minutes, in a video clip, in half a minute, to pass that secret from one to one. That is wrong. The secret already been passed. The secret already been passed to Sayyidina al-Mahdi alayhi salam, to Sayyidina Ali. But it takes time. That's why, because it's heavy, it's carrying a lot of pressure. It's carrying the whole world. It's carrying on the shoulder of this awliya, the burden of every murid. So he was like, al-istilam wa taslim. Al-taslim wa al-istilam. When there is a minister and they assign a new minister, so one passing of power, it takes time. So he was passing that power every after Fajr prayer, he was passing to Sayyidina Shahi Mardan, passing to him, calling on him, I'm ready for you, Ya Shahi Mardan. As soon as say Ya Shahi Mardan, Sayyidina Ali appears. And take from him, take from him, take from him, take from him. And Mawlana did not leave dunya until he gave every single murid to Sayyidina Ali. And to Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, from these two sides. Before he left dunya, one by one. And that's why Tariqa al-Naqshbandiya, al-Aliya or Nazimiya, it's there now on the lowest gear. Lowest gear?
No.
On the lowest acceleration until signs of more appear of the last days and the appearance of Mahdi alayhi salam, it will boom up. It will be boosted up, that covers this whole dunya. And murids of Awliyaullah, of Naqshbandi Tariqa, of Mawlana Sheikh, they will be like stars in dark nights. Now, slowly, no Sultan Awliya now. Sultan Awliya is Shah Mardan. That Mawlana Grand Sheikh said, he was sitting on the camel. When the caravan coming from the other side, Sahaba asked, did you see Sayyidina Ali? They said, yeah, he was sitting on the camel and say, Salamu alaykum. Awliyaullah, he's shaheed. Bal ahya'un inda rabbihim yurzaqoon. They are for sure, they are living in the presence of their Lord, provided with what? Provided with anything they like for the followers of, for the Ummatul Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the followers of Tariqa. They are waiting to give at any moment, so they are able to come out from in Hayatul Barzakh they are free because they are alive. Shuhada. They have a life. There is a life between grave and day of resurrection, which called Hayatul Barzakh. The life of this of the time between grave and resurrection day, the inner life, and their spirit is free. They can move, and you can see them if you have power to see. That's people see in dreams. Some people they say I saw a vision, like the dream that I saw. It was between sleeping and non-sleeping. So your secrets now, it's not in anyone's hand. It is with Shahi Mardan. You are connected now. This whole tariqah is connected to Sayyidina Ali, and from Sayyidina Ali, Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. No one can change. قُضِيَ الْأَمْرُ الَّذِي فِيهِ تَسْتَفْتِيَانِ. Explain, translate.
The matter you are asking about is done and finished.
The matter that you are asking about to be explained, to give a fatwa about it, or to express that of Sayyidina Yusuf, he said it's done. He gave them the answer, one is going to die by birds eating his head, and the other one is going to be in the king courtyard. The matter is finished. Those who are going to disappear from dunya, they are mahrumun, deprived from the secrets of realities of the divine presence, are deprived from it, and those who are not deprived, they are in it. Ahlul Tara'iq, Ahlul Turuq, Ahlul Mahabbat al-Nabi, Ahlul Sunnah wal-Jama'ah are not going to be deprived. The others are going to be deprived. قُضِيَ الْأَمْرُ الَّذِي فِيهِ تَسْتَفْتِيَانِ. Finish! The amr, the order is done, is stamped, is certified, is authenticized. No one can change. Don't look here or there. Look that your secrets in the hand of Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq and Sayyidina Ali to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's why he was calling Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan, Aina Anta?
Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan,
Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan,
Ya Shahi Mardan,
Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan,
Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan.
Do you feel something? Goosebumps? Goosebumps? You felt something like Kash'arira? Kash'arira? You feel something. Everyone felt something. Because we are calling in Jama'ah. If we call in private, that's not your level yet. Wali can call private, but for others, call Jama'ah. Another time. Ya Shahi Mardan,
Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan, Ya Shahi Mardan.
What do you think he's saying? You are calling on him. What he is doing? He's taking every one of us by name to presence of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Everyone is being brought into the presence of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Those who are here, their relatives, their friends, the one they love, all of them, they entered in that manifestation that they took all of you to the presence of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Those who did not show up, did not care, we leave them to what they like to do. We are on the side of Shahi Mardan and Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, and they are, I don't know where. They know themselves better. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us permission to enter into His divine presence.
Amen.
As Sayyidina Abu Yazid al-Bastami was saying, Ya Rabbi, kayfa al-wusulu ilayk? How I can reach you? How we can reach the divine presence? He heard a voice saying, Utruk nafsaka wa ta'al. Fansalakht. كما تنسلخ الحية من جسدها أو من جلدها. He said, when he heard that voice, leave yourself and come, I pulled my soul, my nafs, out of my soul like the snake pull its skin out of its body. I did that. You have been granted that. You have. You have been granted that because Allah is generous. Prophet is rahmatan lil alamin. Sahabatun Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam wa khulafaihi ar-rashidun. Kurama. كرمهم فائض علينا. So that these kind of sessions rarely to happen. Cannot be repeated. But as I said, everyone present, his family is not even not present. Everyone present, he is representing his family, his children, his ancestor, his descendants, everyone is part of what he will get from this session of manifestation. Ya Shahi Mardan! يا شاهي مردان. Allah knows best. We say, may Allah forgive us.
Ameen.
And forgive them.
Ameen.
Those who always shows enmity and animosity, always, they show whatever you do for them, whenever you do for them. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Utruk al-Turka ma tarakukum." Is that?
Yes. Leave them alone as long as they leave you alone.
Leave them alone as long as they leave you alone. Utruk al-Turka ma tarakukum means don't trust them. There is no benefit except the cream of them. Yes, the cream of them is cream of them. But in general, don't. Because you don't know when they flip on you. They are flipping. But we have Shahi Mardan.
Allah Akbar.
We have Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq.
Allah.
We have Sayyidina Umar. We have Sayyidina Osman.
Allah.
We have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar.
Allahu
Akbar.
Walillahi
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us.
Ameen.
And I will ask Muhammad al-Saggaf, he is Sayyid, living in Madinatul Munawwara, to make dua for us.
Don't miss the opportunity of tonight, the manifestation. Please give for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshallah.
I don't know. No.
اللهم لك الحمد حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه لا
نحمد
ثناء عليك انت كما اثنيت على نفسك.
امين.
اللهم لك الحمد عدد اوراقك جل وعلا من يوم خلقت الدنيا الى يوم القيامه من انت مضى. ولك الحمد عدد ذرات الرمال وما تطاير منها من يوم خلقت الدنيا الى يوم القيامه في كل يوم الف مره. ولك الحمد يا الله عدد قطرات الأمطار وما تساقط منها من يوم خلقت الدنيا إلى يوم القيامة في كل يوم ألف مرة.
آمين.
لك الحمد يا ربنا حتى ترضى، ولك الحمد إذا رضيت، ولك الحمد بعد الرضا. لا نحصي ثناء عليك. يا ربي إنا عاجزون. يا ربي إنا عاجزون. لا نحصي ثناء عليك. وأنت القائل في كتابك وإن تعدوا نعمة الله لا تحصوها. فكيف بالنعم يا الله. لك الحمد يا الله ولك الشكر يا الله. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد في الأولين، وصل على سيدنا محمد في الآخرين، وصل على سيدنا محمد وآله في كل وقت وحين. يا الله صل عليه عدد ما صلى عليه المصلون، وصل عليه عدد ما غفل عن الصلاة عليه الغافلون.
آمين.
اللهم يا الله إنا نتوجه إليك بجاه حبيبك المصطفى
صلى الله.
يا سيدي. آمين. يا رسول الله.
آمين.
يا سيدي يا حبيب الله. يا سيدي يا سيدي يا حبيبي يا رسول الله. إنا نتوسل بك، نتوسل بك إلى ربك يا رسول الله. أغثنا يا رسول الله. أغثنا يا رسول الله. نشكو إليك حالنا ونشكو إليك ضعفنا ونشكو إليك ما نزل بنا من بلاء. ولا أرحم بنا منك ولا أرأف بنا منك. آمين. يا رسول الله.
آمين.
يا رسول الله.
آمين.
يا رسول الله.
آمين.
إنا نناجيك.
آمين.
نناجيك ونطلب منك أن تسأل لنا الله أن يرفع عنا ما نزل من بلاء.
آمين.
يا رب ارفع عنا كل سوء.
آمين.
احفظنا من بين أيدينا ومن خلفنا وعن أيماننا وعن شمائلنا.
آمين.
ومن فوقنا، ونعوذ بك أن نغتال من تحتنا.
آمين.
ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الظالمين.
آمين.
يا الله يا الله.
سبحان الله.
لا تؤاخذنا إن
نسينا أو أخطأنا.
آمين.
ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا.
آمين.
ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به.
آمين.
واعف عنا.
آمين.
واعف عنا.
آمين.
واعف عنا.
آمين.
واغفر لنا وارحمنا.
آمين.
أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين.
آمين.
يا الله يا الله يا الله اغفر لنا ذنوبنا.
آمين.
وتب علينا يا الله.
آمين.
اغفر لنا الذنوب.
آمين.
وتب علينا لنتوب.
آمين.
يا الله.
آمين.
يا من يعلم كل شيء.
آمين.
يا من بيده كل شيء. يا الله.
آمين.
يا الله.
آمين.
تب علينا يا الله.
آمين يا رب.
اغفر لنا الذنوب.
آمين.
نقنا من الذنوب والخطايا كما ينقى الثوب الأبيض من الدنس.
آمين.
يا الله طهرنا يا الله.
آمين.
آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها.
آمين.
يا الله. هذا وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. والحمد لله رب العالمين. الفاتحة. معذر علي طالب.